I've never taken any of my cars to an automatic car wash, whether it's the Porsche, the Beamer, or the family SUV. I've always been hand washing them using my homemade pressure washer setup. Actually, you can see my install of the setup right above or below. But I recently got this loaner from Tesla. It's a 2018 Model S with 34,000 miles, but Tesla delivered it to me in a very filthy state. So I don't like to drive dirty cars, but I also will not hand wash this car. So I'm gonna finally take my vehicle, or my temporary vehicle, to an automatic car wash to see what automatic car washing is and if it's gonna scratch this already scratched vehicle even further. So enjoy this quick clip. And when I say it's dirty, I mean it's dirty. I mean, look at all this staining on the side. Look at all of this. Look how filthy the wheels are. This obviously will not wash off. Look at all the leaves here. Look at all the dirt. You see? There's so much dirt caked in here. Look what happens when we open the trunk. It's also dirty in the trunk. It hasn't been vacuumed, I think, ever. Don't worry, these are my bags. I'm going to Home Depot afterwards. But look, in the back, well, there you go. In the back, check this out. This is all filthy. It hasn't been vacuumed in weeks. All of this is dirty. Look at all of that. Ah, so filthy. So I'm curious to see what happens if I take you to that automatic car wash and these guys will clean it in and out. I'm gonna get the works to see how good of a job they do. From the car wash, I put the car in the same spot. Initially, I filmed a clip right in the parking lot of the car wash because there were some issues, but for some reason the audio was damaged. So this is 10 minutes later after I got home, and this is what the car looks like. First of all, I've got to say Tesla paint is actually pretty good compared to my other cars. This is actually not bad at all. Now, this car is very beat up. It's got 34,000 miles or so, and it's been abused by customers, but the paint still shines. Now, the car wash obviously didn't get to all the nooks and crannies and crevices and whatnot. There was a couple of black marks here that I simply rubbed off with my fingers after the car wash. Also, the wheels don't necessarily look very clean. You see, look, check this out. There's a lot of this caked on dirt that the car wash didn't pick up. Obviously, there's a lot of overspray. I suspect that overspray might be from tire shine, which, if you look at it closely, and I don't know if the camera's gonna pick it up, but look, it's missing here. Yes, it's shiny here, then it's missing here, and it's shiny here. So if you get tire shine as an option, I say skip it. Not only does it look spotty, but it actually damages the tires in the long run, because wet looking or darker looking tires attract more sun, so that the tires get hotter and they tend to crack. So I always avoid tire shine in any of my cars. But going around, let's see, did the tire wash pick up all of that? Nope. Look, actually, right there, see, this was still there. One of my biggest disappointments about this car wash is the fact that I paid for a vacuum inside, and check this out, they completely missed the trunk. So the trunk hasn't been touched at all. And yeah, this is a service that you pay for. So they missed that. Then let's see, on this side, same issue with the tire shine. It's missing here and it's shiny sort of in parts. Pretty bad job. In the back, they actually did a fairly decent job. I've got two baby seats, but when you look at the vacuuming job, it's not necessarily 100% right, but it's there. That's, the back is acceptable. Now, the front, I have to say, not very acceptable because, yeah, you look at this. You have all this dirt here. You have all of that that they did not vacuum, and we got seats which haven't been vacuumed, and of course the center console, which was dirty before, is now still dirty. So that is inside, and again on the outside, this was there. This is some sort of a door ding, so we're not gonna worry about that. The wheels again in the front, the tire shine that we paid for, again most of it is gone, so they use some sort of a crappy tire shine. And then in the front, that's probably the biggest disappointment. The car wash completely did not get the front. All these sort of, these are not even bug stains. These are just some regular caked on dirt stains, which should have been picked up by the car wash, but they haven't been picked up. So yeah, this is also a waste of money. Now, speaking of a waste of money, this goes to show you why I hand wash all of my vehicles. And I would never trust someone else to do the washing for me at a car wash. I do have a detailer that I work with, and he details my cars once a year, doing ceramic coating and all of that. But for hand washing, I do it myself because, as you can tell, you can't really trust not only an automatic car wash, but the guys or girls who are doing the work afterwards, vacuuming and detailing and all that stuff, to do it, because this would be a major, and it has always been a major disappointment. For example, when I first opened up the trunk right outside of their facility, all the foam came out because they just forgot to wipe it. So yeah, very, very disappointed. But at the very least, I now have a very clean loaner, which I can tell Mr. Elon Musk that I've cleaned and made sure it looks good. Because I really do like this car. Driving on airbags is an amazing, amazing feeling. But anyways, I hope this video gave you an amazing feeling, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Oh, I also ended up buying this thing because the inside of this car stinks.